what's a correlation? Well, a correlation is a relationship between two variables, where changes in one are systematically associated with changes in the other. We can have positive correlations, where increases in one variable are associated with increases in another variable. Or we can have negative correlations, where increases in one variable are associated with decreases in the other variable. Let's imagine that we wanted to do a correlational study looking at the relationship between hours spent on Facebook and emotional well-being. If we were to find a positive correlation, it would look something like this. Notice that as the number of hours on Facebook increases, so does emotional well-being. But if we found a negative correlation, it would look just the opposite. We would find that as the number of hours on Facebook increased, emotional well-being decreased. And of course, it's also possible that we might find there's no relationship between these two variables. They're not related at all. And if we did, if we found no correlation, it would look something like this. So notice that the line would be flat rather than going up or down. One of the mistakes that people make is that they infer causation from correlation. But just because two variables are correlated does not mean that one necessarily causes the other. It's possible that one does, and we would have to do some experimental research in order to uncover that causal connection. But the correlation alone can't be used to infer cause. Right? So in places where there's a lot of mosquitoes, there's high levels of malaria. It would be a mistake to infer that mosquitoes cause malaria, right? Obviously, the malaria virus is what causes malaria. Mosquitoes are the way that it spreads. So we have this correlation, and we need to then uncover what the relationship is between the variables. And sometimes there's a direct cause, but oftentimes there is not. Epidemiological research is research that uses correlational data to look at prevalence and incidence rates. If you recall, prevalence is how many people in a population have a given disorder, and incidence is how many people in the population develop the disorder over a discrete period of time. And one example of epidemiological data that is relevant to things we study in this course is that in Uganda, there is an 11.8% prevalence rate for symptoms of PTSD. This means that there is a positive correlation between living in Uganda and displaying PTSD symptoms. It doesn't mean that living in Uganda causes PTSD, but it shows that there's a relationship, and it gives researchers information that is important because it will guide future research